Marvin, what do you make of all this?
Man, I don't even have an opinion.
Well, you gotta have an opinion. I mean, do you think that God came down from heaven and stopped...
Oh, what the fuck's happening?
Oh, man. Oh, man, I shot Marvin in the face.
Why the fuck did you do that?
Well, I didn't mean to do it. It was an accident.
Oh, man, I seen some crazy-ass shit in my time, but this...
Chill out, man. I told you it was an accident. You probably... You went over a bump or something.
Hey, the car ain't hit no motherfucking bump.
Hey, look, man, I didn't mean to shoot the son of a bitch. The gun went off. I don't know why.
Well, look at this fucking mess, man. We're on a city street in broad daylight here.
Believe it, man.
Well, believe it now, motherfucker. We gotta get this car off the road. You know, cops tend to notice shit like you're driving a
just
car against this fucking blood.
Just take it to a friendly place, that's all.
This is the Valley, Vincent. Marcellus ain't got no friendly places in the Valley.
But you'll save my fucking town, man.
Shit.
Joe, I don't know what you think you know. But you're wrong.
Like hell I am.
Joe, trust me on this. You've made a mistake. He's a good kid. I understand. You're hot. You're super fucking pissed. We're all real emotional. But you're barking up the wrong tree. I know this man. He wouldn't do that.
You don't know jack shit. I do. The cocksucker tipped off the cops and a Mr. Brown and Mr. Blue killed.
Mr. Blue is dead?
Dead as Dillinger.
How do you know all this?
The only one I wasn't 100% on. I should have my fucking head examined going ahead when I wasn't 100%.
That's your proof?
You don't need proof when you have instinct. I ignored it before, but no more.
You lost your fucking mind.
Joe, you're making a terrible mistake. I'm not gonna let you make it.
Come on, guys. Nobody wants this. We're supposed to be fucking professionals.
All right, look. It's been quite a long time. A lot of jobs. There's no need for this, man. Let's just put our guns down and let's settle this with a fucking conversation.
Joe, if you kill that man, you die next. Repeat, if you kill that man, you die next.
Larry, we have been friends and you respect my dad and I respect you, but I will put fucking bullets right through your heart. You put that fucking gun down now.
God damn you, Joe. Don't make me do this.
Larry, stop pointing that fucking gun at my dad!
Well, if this is it, old boy, I hope you don't mind if I go out speaking to Kings.
By all means, Captain.
There's a special rung in hell reserved for people who waste good scotch. Seeing as I may be rapping on the door momentarily. I must say, damn good stuff, sir. Now, about this pickle we find ourselves in. It would appear there's only one thing left for you to do.
And what would that be?
Stiglitz.
See how feeders into your Nazi boss.
You'll explain to me why we shouldn't blow both of you to pieces.
Dwight, what have you done?
Exactly what I had to. Every step of the way.
No! It isn't right! There wasn't no tape over his mouth! How come there's tape over his mouth?
Where the fight counts for a lot.
You tricked McCarthy, but it will do you no good.
But there's nothing like having your friend show up with lots of guns.
No! McCarthy, you shit!
The girls all know the score. No escape. No surrender. No mercy. We gotta kill every last rat bastard one of them. Every last one. Not for revenge, Not because they deserve it. Not because it'll make the world a better place. We need a heap of bloody bodies so when mob boss Valenquist looks over his charts of profits and losses, he'll see what it cost him to mess with the girls of Old Town. The Valkyrie at my side is shouting and laughing with the pure, hateful, bloodthirsty joy of the slaughter.
You really want me to shake your hand? I insist.
If you insist.
Send this ugly son of a bitch to hell. You killed OB? He is worth 10 of you. Warren, can I kill him?
Say adios to your huevos.